Thank you. So today I'll be talking about Sailor. It's a web framework in Lua. And among other things, I will also talk about all the path that took me to it, the current state of web development in Lua, and other stuff. But I'll begin by introducing myself. So I'm Etiene Dalcol. I'm an undergrad student at PUC-Rio. And I'm currently at an exchange program at Ensa-Bretagne. And this is my contact in case you want to talk to me later. So why I came to the Lua world? I heard it looks cool. You could make games with it. Thank you, Angry Birds, once again. It's made in my home country and in my university, to be more precise. So I was just next to the big shots. I had classes with Hisham, with Roberto. I could just go in the Lab Lua to take doubts any time I wanted. So it was a great opportunity, and I thought I just had to learn it before I left this environment. So I decided I was going to learn it. And I could brag about it later. Yes, I study at the same university that Roberto gives classes, and obviously, it doesn't mean anything, but people don't need to know about it. So, why I started coding Sailor? I needed to develop something real, because tutorial and manuals, they don't work for me, not at all. So, I just need to find a goal. I just need to find something to code, and then I need to find out how to do it. Obviously, this has some problems. Sometimes this leaves gaps in the middle of stuff I didn't learn, but this is the only thing that works for me. So, okay, I wanted to code something real in Lua to learn it, but why something in the web development area? Well, this is something that I had already some previous knowledge. I'm a PHP developer. All my internships during university were in PHP. I started in PHP a long time ago just for curiosity. So I knew a little bit from web development. So it's a little bit like learning languages. So my native language is Portuguese, and if I wanted to learn a new language faster, I would pick something that is closer to what I already know. So, for example, Japanese will be more difficult than French. So this is the same reason that I wanted to develop something in the web development in Lua, because I thought I could use something to make me progress faster. So I started with Sailor at New Year's Eve. Unfortunately, it was not a New Year's Eve resolution, because that would be the first one ever I would accomplish. But it's a shame. So that was it. That was the 31st December 2013. And I managed to run a Lua script at Apache web server. And yay, I did something. And a few days later, I had that. That was the version 0.1 of Sailor. As you can see, I could pass variables, I could use JavaScript in the middle of it. I had a simple controller and views separated. And some days later, I had that, which has already many other things that I'll go into details later. So what exactly is it? Like the title implies, it's an MVC web framework. It's completely written in Lua, apart from some JavaScript modules we imported to translate Lua to JavaScript. I will also get into details about it later. It's compatible with various web servers, Apache, Nginx, and the third one is unknown. I had a lot of trouble finding about it. But it's a very, very light one. You can pack it very easily. It well, it works a little bit like Lua. It occupies not much space, and you click it, and it works, and, well, it's cute. But it's hard to find more about it. So it's compatible with Linux, Windows, and Mac. I don't have yet a Mac documentation for how to install it and how to use it, because honestly, I just ran it, I saw it works, and that was it. I didn't really spend time developing and checking. So, but I'll take more look about it later. So like Lua, it's an MIT license. So feel free to fork, use, whatever. And it's currently in the pre-alpha version 0.2 on Mars. And in case anyone wondered, yes, the version names are inspired by Sailor Moon. So what does it do? It has a simple URL routine, session cookies, it parses Lua pages. It is a module inside CGI Lua. It's very interesting. I'll also talk about it later, so I'll just pass through the list. You can send emails using Lua socket. It has a basic ORM system. It's not yet, how can I say, fully functional. It lacks some features, but it works. We have an input validation system, which I release as a separated module on Lua Rocks that I call Valua. You can use it to validate user inputs, like verify if a string is a valid email, a valid date. And many times this is very useful when dealing with forms. So in the web world, this is very necessary for a framework. It already comes with a basic login and authentication system, so you don't have to develop a login system every time you're going to make something. It has a basic form generation inspired by your model. So if you want to save on user, and so you can generate the inputs, it's easy to use. It is integrated with Twitter Bootstrap, so your app doesn't look ugly right out of the box, which is good. It has a simple app generator just for Linux and Mac. And it's a common line, Sailor create application name on directory. And it will simply copy paste a blank application to your desired directory. And the premium feature is Lua at client. I'll go into details about this now. So one thing about web development is that usually you have to learn many things to make a website. So you have to learn a server-side language, a client-side language, the visual stuff like HTML and CSS. So there are many technologies you have to know about. And I was wondering, what if you could use the same programming language for both server-side and client-side? So this thing was in the roadmap just from the beginning of Sailor, but I actually didn't develop this myself, which is the great thing about open source projects. Sometimes it just develops by itself. So somebody joined in and, hey, I made this. And it was exactly something I was looking for since the beginning. So if you don't want to, you don't have to ever look at JavaScript. You can code the client side in Lua as well. It uses the Lua 5.1.js by Alexander. Thank you. And that's it. So it makes life a little easier, especially if you're a newcomer. So it eliminates one more step. So what's currently bad about Sailor? Well, like I said, it's in early development and just started it in last New Year's Eve. And things are changing fast. It's still in pre-alpha and, well, so some things might broke as we develop stuff. So this is a bad side about it. It still lacks features, since we are still improving it and adding more stuff all the time. And the documentation, of course, is a little poor because I'm doing it all myself, and I like to program. I leave the documentation for later, like everyone here. So that's it. But is it still worth using it, collaborating, and trying to improve it? I think so. I'll show you some statistics for the current web development world, and they're very, very interesting. For example, as you can see over there, 82% of all websites in the world use PHP. And when we talk about client-side languages, it's even a bigger monopoly. As you can see, on JavaScript is used in 88% of all websites. And when we talk about frameworks and content management systems, it's pretty much the same. So of all websites of the world, 62% don't use anything. And 33% use WordPress, which accounts for 60% of all websites that use some kind of control of content management system. And WordPress is developed in PHP. As for web servers, the most used one is Apache, followed by Nginx. So why are these technologies the most used? I mean, it's not really because they are the best ones, but because they are the easier ones to use. As a PHP developer myself, I can tell that I really prefer writing a text file and copy-pasting to the directory that my web server reads, instead of spending one day long preparing my developing environment and starting to debug things before I even wrote the first line of code. So, of course, I'm speaking for myself, but obviously there are a lot of people that are in the same situation as me. The thing I think about Lua is that it has the potential to cover this. As you can see, a lot of people, I have two examples here. They date from around 2010, about people saying that they would love to use Lua for web development, but they either didn't have the tools or the framework or whatever. It was just too difficult to find a community. But they thought that Lua could be a really interesting tool for this purpose. And it is. With the talk about performance, and so this is an average speech test of various different algorithms like binary tree search, pi digits, and this is the comparison between many languages using Apache web server. So as you can see, Lua is faster than PHP, and LuaJIT is faster than Java and JavaScript. So in terms of performance, Lua is great. And I also think it can do the same job with more elegance and with a faster learning curve. So when you talk more about Lua for web, there are some problems. Even though it's not something new, as you can see, CGI Lua exists since 1995, and the Kepler project since 2003, is still in early state. There's not a lot of people that use it when you compare to the other things. For example, when you see that PHP takes 82% of the market. And it's difficult to find information about it, so it's still a tough job to start programming in Lua for web. So not that there wasn't already tools. For example, Orbit exists since 2007, but it's not really known. Maybe it's known inside the Lua community, but it's outside it, nobody ever heard about it. It is the closest one to Sailor's concept. It's also an MVC framework. It's very complex. It works great, but it has no significant updates since 2010. And when you try to develop something in it, you don't have more. You don't have any more some support. You don't have a community around it, so it's a little tough. There is Love It. That began in 2011. It is the most popular of the Lua frameworks I found about, but it's still not very popular outside the Lua community. But it is an intense development. There are people really working on it. And well, its concept is completely different from Sailor's concept. So Love It is a port from Node.js to Lua. That claims to be 2 to 4 times faster, which is a great benchmark. But when you go to Levit's website, it's difficult. It doesn't have any documentation, at least there wasn't the last time I checked. And it admits that you already know Node.js, and they will do the same thing in Lua. So if you're completely new to web development, Levit will be useless. Because you need to learn Node.js first and then try to do the same thing in Lua. So this turns to be many, many steps. The newest one and the best one of these three, in my opinion, is Lapis, which is also in intense development. It's not exactly in Lua, it's in MoonScript, which is a language that compiles to Lua. But you can use Lua to develop a website using Lapis. It's very, very well documented. You can go to the website, you'll find all the information needed to start working on it. The bad things about it is that it's only compatible with OpenRC, which is the NGX model to run Lua. And well, the templater is a bad thing and a good thing. That depends on what purpose you're going to use. So it has a templater to auto-generate HTML. And if you're developing something from scratch, this is good because that makes your job faster. But if you already have an HTML layout ready that you want to use, you have to change a lot of stuff and that makes a lot of job. So it depends. It's not an MVC framework out of the box. You could use it to turn it into an MVC framework, but it's not already structured like that. So for someone that doesn't have a lot of knowledge, they could be lost or they could develop something very messy. And of course, there are some others that I didn't mention it here because they are very, very old, they're abandoned projects, they don't have any documentation, or maybe there are some others that I never heard. If you know any other tools for web development, please tell me. But back to Sailor. So how do you get it? You have two options, which is from Lua Rocks, you just install it, Sailor, and it's done. But if you want to collaborate and get the latest updates, you can get it from GitHub. And a setup example, install Lua, install Lua Rocks, install the database server that you prefer. I have been using MySQL, but you can use Postgres or whatever. On the website, there are listed all the web servers that you can use. I use it with Apache, but you can also use the other two servers I mentioned. And then you just create your app. So you use Sailor create, the application name, and the directory you want to put it. So you create a structure pretty much like that. So there is a configuration folder that has the configuration files, the controllers folders, that you can create a .lua file and operator controller, which is basically a table with functions indexed to it, and it function is an action. So it function is a page from your website, a layout folder for your HTML templates and whatever, the models folder for your entities, the public folder, which is for, I don't know, JavaScript that you want to include, external stuff. The runtime folder is a folder used by Sailor for sessions and other things that you have to create and deal during runtime. And the views, which are the files of the views, and they are not actually Lua files, they are .lp, which stands for Lua page. That works a little bit like PHP. You have a normal HTML file, and in the middle of it, you can use angle brackets and open a Lua code and write Lua code in the middle of it, and it worked. So, an example, that is our controller, our site controller, and it has our function index. I created a little string right there, hi. And after it, I rendered the view. So we have a page object, which is an object that contains the functions that we are going to use in Sailor. You can render views, you can write directly to the page, you can change the template. And okay, so down here, we have our Lua page file. Like I said, it's basic HTML with Lua stuff in the middle. And in here, we have three different uses of Lua. So the first one is the regular one, which is by default the server-side Lua. So right there, I pass a variable from the controller. And here, I just printed it. Down here are two grouped uses. Lua above creates a block of code that runs both on server side and client side. So you can write one function and use it from both server side and client side codes later. So for example, here I declared a little message. Here I printed it. The angle brackets like this are just like a page print function. And down here, I used a JavaScript function to make an alert message that gets the same message. So I wrote this block of code one time, and I could use it one more time here and here. And it will generate this. So you can see up there a message from the controller, and here the same message being printed from the server and being used at client side. So that's it. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, if you want to contact me, if you want to see more examples, just go ahead.
Hello, I just had a little question. In the last example, you showed that a conditional statement, yes, and you needed to say page print and the message. Is it possible to close the angle bracket and print the HTML you wanted to output, and then between angle brackets say end?
Yes, it's possible.
Okay, I think that it's just handier than using print directly. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot for your presentation. And I skipped information about global variables like PHP, session, server. Does it include in your framework?
They are stored at one global variable, which is, so we have a global variable, which is Sailor, that contains a table with many information, and there is session, headers, and lots of stuff.
Cookies?
Yes.
Right.
As far as I know, OpenRest has many coroutines. How your global variable deals with that?
I don't know. To be honest, like I said, I have collaborators that were working with me, and I'm dealing with Modlua and Apache, and a colleague, Felipe Dragon, is dealing with the OpenRest part. So he will be the best one to answer your question, but I can send you his contact later.
Okay.
How JS object works here? This one?
Yes. So it uses the VM that you made.
Yeah, it obviously it uses the VM, but if you're using my VM, there is no JS object there. So you coded it?
Oh, Felipe coded, yes.
Oh, okay. How it works?
I don't know.
Oh, okay. So the correct answer is looking at the source. Luke, can I ask you to contribute it maybe to the Lua 5.1.js, because it's missing this thing,
okay.
And it's integral
no problem
to this?
I can ask you to send the patches. So, yes, there is a project on GitHub that has everything there.
Okay.
Do you try to make Sailor as much user-friendly to ex-PHP developers as possible, or do you target other audience as well?
I'm sorry, I didn't understand your question.
So it is very similar to PHP. Do you try to make it as much friendly to ex-PHP developers as possible?
Yes, I am. That is a goal I'm trying to accomplish as a PHP developer myself, because I think Lua has all the potential to replace PHP, because it's easy to use and it has a great performance. So we need more people in the community, and I think that will go great.
What about PHP standard library? Do you try to copy it somehow?
No, I'm not trying to copy the library, because obviously PHP has some mistakes. And well, I don't want to import everything from PHP with all the PHP problems. I want to import the PHP developers. So it's different.
Are you planning to add tweak style templates to your framework?
Tweak style templates?
Yes, some templates like tweak for PHP.
I don't understand.
I mean not just tags with as in PHP, but some algorithmic construction into HTML that simplify the situation.
Oh yes, like this, you mean? Oh, sorry.
And
we have a basic template using Twitter Bootstrap, so right out of the box, it doesn't look plain text. But you can use any other template you want. So Twitter Bootstrap is an open source project that has buttons and, well, many HTML objects and elements that you can use. So I bundled it with Sailor.
I understand, but I meant something resembling conditional compilation.
No, I don't know.
I saw you using Apache. Is anyone in the world still using Apache?
A lot of people.
We actually have Nginx author in the auditory here. And no Apache contributors, I believe.
Yeah,
only
60%. Only 60% of the world is using Apache. So.
Almost nobody.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you very much.